I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my turn till I met you. I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my turn, yeah, till I met. You call my name and I ran out of that place, out of the darkness into your glorious day. You call my name and I ran out of that place, out of the darkness.
everyone. How are you today? My name is Ashley, and I'm here to do the memory verse with you. I cannot wait to do this verse with you because it talks about how just as Christ was raised from the dead into new life, we also can experience new life by putting our faith in Him. So here's the verse. I'm gonna do it, and then we can practice together. Just as Christ was raised from the dead, through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. Romans 6:4. That's it. Now let's practice together. Repeat after me. Just as Christ was raised from the dead, through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. Romans 6:4. Awesome job, everyone. Now let's do that one more time together. Just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. Romans 6:4. Awesome work, everyone. That's it for today. Bye.
Reese, I'm a cartoon character. Look at me. Whoa, look at you. Reese, we're both cartoon characters.
Yeah, we are. This is how we're going to tell the story. Jesus showed us His love by the way He treated the people who are around Him, and also by the miracles He did while He was here on earth.
Let's just say, Jesus was a pretty awesome guy.
Yeah, He was. Everything Jesus did got the people talking. They wondered if Jesus was the king God had promised to send to save them from the wrong things they had done.
So, was Jesus like Superman and just didn't realize He had special powers that God would use to save the world?
No. Jesus knew exactly why God had sent Him to earth. He came to take the punishment for the wrong things we do and to give us life that would never end. Because God hates sin, but loves us, He planned for Jesus to take all the punishment for the sins of all the people in the world.
Well, that's like so many people. Hundreds, thousands, millions!
That's why His death on the cross was so painful. It was definitely the biggest way that Jesus showed us love. He willingly gave up His life so that we could be forgiven by God. But the best part is that Jesus didn't stay dead. After He died, a huge stone was rolled in front of a cave where Jesus' body was. There were even some guards in front of it.
That's right, but nothing can stop Jesus. 3 days later, God brought Him back to life.
So what you're saying is, Jesus is alive!
That's right! Some of Jesus' friends went to see the cave where He was buried, but when they got there, He was gone!
Then, suddenly, two angels appeared and said, "Jesus is not here! He has risen just as He said He would!"
Just met some angels and get this, Jesus is alive! Hashtag He ain't in there, hashtag Easter extravaganza!
Actually, they ran to go tell Jesus' followers all about it. But on the way, something pretty amazing happened.
Oh, I know. They found a giant Easter basket, and it had the golden egg inside of it, full of chocolate bunnies and peeps!
No, not that. Jesus met them.
Say what?
You heard me right. Jesus appeared to them on the road and said,
"Ta-da! It's me. I'm alive."
He could have said something like that, but the Bible tells us that He greeted them and told them not to be afraid, but to go and tell everyone else He was alive.
What great news!
On that same day, two of Jesus' followers were walking to a town close by.
Next stop, Emmaus.
As they were walking, they talked about everything that had happened. Suddenly, Jesus came up and started walking with them. But they didn't even recognize Him.
Well, I'm sure He was the last person they were expecting.
Jesus asked, "What are you guys talking about?" And they looked at Him like, "Where have you been?"
They probably thought He'd been hiding under a rock.
So the two men, still not recognizing who they were talking to, told Him all about who Jesus was and what had happened to Him. They just didn't get it.
Oh, they about to find out.
As they approached Emmaus, they invited Jesus to have dinner, even though they still didn't know who he was. Sure enough, Jesus joined them at the table, taking the bread and giving thanks.
Oh, come on, guys. It's this guy. It's Jesus.
Well, as Jesus broke the bread to give to them, it was like a light bulb went off in their heads.
Ding!
As soon as they realized it was Jesus, he disappeared from their sight. Can you believe it?
I believe it. Jesus really did come back to life.
He did. He appeared to over 500 people, so we would know it's true.
Jesus' power over death is good news for us, too. When you admit that you've done wrong things
and believe in your heart that Jesus died and came back to life,
you can be saved and live forever with God in heaven one day.
That's all because we know Jesus is alive.
You came from heaven. You loved me. You loved me. Gave up all you had. You saved me. You saved me. Your life was given. You love me, you love me, so I live forever. You save me, you save me. You made a way for me. You came to set me free. I believe in Jesus. I believe he came to save. I believe in Jesus Christ. Trust in Jesus, I'll live to follow him. I will trust in Jesus Christ. You came from heaven, you loved me, you loved me. Gave up all you had, you saved me, you saved me. Your life was given, you loved me, you loved me. So I live forever. You saved me, you saved me. You made a way for me. You came to set me free. I believe in Jesus. I believe he came to save. I believe in Jesus Christ. Trust in Jesus, I'll live to follow him. I will trust in Jesus Christ. Clap, clap, clap if you feel it. Sing, sing, sing like you mean it. Clap, clap, clap if you feel it. I believe, I believe, I believe. Clap, clap, clap if you feel it. Sing, sing, sing like you mean it. Clap, clap, clap if you feel it. I believe, I believe, I believe. Clap, clap, clap if you feel it. Sing, sing, sing like you mean it. Clap, clap, clap if you feel it. Jesus Christ. I will trust in Jesus. I'll live to follow him. I will trust in Jesus Christ. Clap, clap, clap if you feel it. Sing, sing, sing like you mean it.
God's Story, Easter. So part of God's story is about Easter, and it begins like this. You might know Easter as the Sunday a ginormous bunny hides chocolate inside plastic eggs. But Easter is really all about how much Jesus loves us and how God sent him to rescue us. Remember how the Jews, God's special family, were waiting for a king to come rescue them? Well, Jesus was the king, and this rescue was the whole reason he came to earth. God had already rescued the Jews once before, but this time it was going to include everyone. So one night, Jesus told his friends about the rescue. Exciting, right? But talking about this rescue was sad. That's because Jesus was going to rescue the world by dying. Kids, every mean or bad thing we do deserves punishment. By dying, Jesus took our punishment. Lots of things in life have good parts and bad parts. And just like candy bars are mostly good, as long as you brush your teeth after you eat one, this story is a really good one. Anyway, talking about the rescue made Jesus sad, since he didn't really want to die. Thankfully, we can talk to God when we're sad, so Jesus took a few friends into a garden to pray. In the garden, a guy named Judas, who people thought was Jesus' friend, came with some people to help arrest Jesus. Peter, one of Jesus' true friends, was so mad he cut off a servant's ear with his sword. But Jesus didn't want his friends to hurt others, so Jesus healed the ear and let them arrest him. Then Jesus was taken to trial. One of the most powerful men in the city, Pontius Pilate, wanted to let Jesus go. But many of the people wanted Jesus to die. They didn't believe he was the Son of God or any kind of king. Even after all the miracles Jesus did, like healing sick people and making blind people see, they didn't believe in him. The people were so mad, they started yelling, "Kill him!" So Pontius Pilate let the soldiers take Jesus. The soldiers made fun of the idea that Jesus was a king. They put a crown of thorns on his head and nailed him to a cross. Many people watched, but not all of them wanted Jesus to die. His mother and close friends were there too. Just imagine how they must have felt. Once Jesus was up on the cross, the sun stopped shining for 3 whole hours in the middle of the day. But those soldiers kept right on making fun of him. They said, "If you're really God's son, why don't you just call on some angels to save you?" Jesus could have called on angels to save him, but he loved us so much that he wanted to rescue us. So instead, he prayed to God, "Father, I place my life into your hands." At that moment, Jesus died. When he died, the soldiers who had just killed him realized he really was the Son of God. Later, Jesus was put into a tomb and a big rock blocked the entrance. Jesus' friends thought that was the end. But 3 days later, God sent an angel to roll the stone away. Don't worry, Jesus could get out on his own. The angel moved the rock so everybody else could see the tomb was empty. Jesus' friends were the first to stop by the tomb. The angel said, "He has risen!" Which is another way of saying, Jesus is alive. Nobody could believe it. Jesus took our punishment and then proved he really is the Son of God by coming back to life. Now, if we choose to follow Jesus, God forgives us for all the wrong things we do because Jesus already took our punishment. And that's the story of Easter. But that's not all there is. Here's a quick version of what happened after the angel told the good news. Jesus' friends got scared. Jesus appeared to them. They saw his scars. It was really him. Now they could share the good news too. Jesus appeared to more than 500 people. He went back up to heaven. And the best part? He promised to come back someday for everybody who follows him. And all that is a part of God's story.
You to know he's coming again. So go run and tell your family friends. Jesus is alive, yo, sing it again.